Please be seated. Good morning and welcome to the sitting of the Ninth Circuit Bankruptcy Appellate Panel. Let's begin by, let me introduce my panelist. To my left is Judge Gann from the District of Arizona. To my right is Judge Lafferty of the Northern District of California, and I'm Judge Taylor from the Southern District of California. Today, each side will have 15 minutes to present their argument. That's not a lot of time, and so I'll give you a few suggestions. First, the single most important thing you can do is answer our questions. We have read your briefs. We are familiar with the record. We have read the case law. And sometimes we have some legitimate questions, and you do not do yourself a service if you don't answer them. I also remind people that not all questions are intended to be a gotcha. Sometimes we'll ask a question that's really a softball to you. We're trying to get you to emphasize a point because we want to convince one of our fellow panelists that they should go your way. So take them seriously and answer them to the best of your abilities. We'll give the appellant an opportunity to reserve time for rebuttal. And at the end of the argument, we will thank you for it, and we will take the matter under submission. So with that, we'll call the first matter.
In re Aguilar, Jose Joel Aguilar, and Guillermina Aguilar, appellants and pro per.
Please come forward. Good morning. Mr. Aguilar, who will be arguing today? All right. Who?
Victor Rivera.
Yes. I'm sorry, I'm having trouble hearing you. Can you come to the podium? I don't want Ms. Aguilar to have to come to the podium unless she's going to argue. Is she going to argue?
Not really, but I'm going to make a statement whether I want to make regarding the case.
Let me. Who's going to argue? Both of them are going to speak? Okay. And who are you? You're not an attorney?
Victor Rivera.
Yes.
I am helping an interpreter.
Okay, so you're an interpreter. All right, so I'm going to ask that you be sworn at this time. So you should.
Thank you.
Please swear the interpreter.
Mr. Rivera, do you affirm under penalty of perjury that you will make a true cancellation before this court today?
Yes, I do.
All right, thank you. All right. So can you ask them to state their names? We don't have an appellee here today, so there will be no reserve time, so we will
My
now begin.
My name is Victor Rivera, and I am...
You're translating, so you need to... I know who you are. I need to know who they are.
Okay. This is Mrs. Guillermina Aguilar, and this is Mr. Jose Joel Aguilar.
All right. So they may make their presentation to the court. You may translate it.
Entonces, ¿qué quiere decir? He's going to go in Spanish, and I'm going to translate for you.
I understand.
Pues yo quiero ver qué lo que va a pasar sobre el caso.
Okay. He is here this morning presenting his arguments, oral arguments, regarding his case where I am familiar with the case, by the way.
But you cannot give us any of your personal information. You can only translate, and that's what you've sworn under penalty of perjury to do.
Yes.
Okay.
So he say here he's here today to know what's going to happen with his case in regards to the appellees.
Okay.
¿Qué es lo que va a pasar, no sé qué es lo que está pasando.
Tiene que decir más.
Sí, acerca del caso, pues qué es lo que no entiende, quiero saber aún qué es lo que va a pasar.
He wants to know regarding the Bankruptcy Appellate Panel. What is your position in regard to his case with those appellees that are not here today? And they haven't responded to all the documents that he's claiming or complaining.
Well, okay. We're really not here. This isn't the time for us to.
He's giving me very small.
I understand. And I'm going to give you a very small piece back, which is to explain to him that the purpose of today is for them to have an opportunity to orally present the case in their brief.
El momento ahorita que ellos tienen acá para darle a usted la oportunidad que usted explique o exprese todo lo que quiera hablar acerca de esta situación, de su reclamo contra estos bancos que son apelis, se le llaman acá.
Sí. Pues yo lo que digo es que me regresen la propiedad, porque esa propiedad ya está pagada. Y ellos siguen todavía con cobrando la propiedad.
Más que todo, tiene que hablarle acerca del caso. Pero bueno, what he said is that he's asking the Bankruptcy Appellate to help him to recover his property, which is still on their possession, but they haven't made payments for 10 years because this lending institutions are collecting from private mortgage insurances.
That's not the issue. The issue in front of us is whether their bankruptcy case was properly dismissed, correct?
Tiene que decirles que si la corte hizo correctamente o no en tirarle el caso.
Pues
exactamente. En eso no, se trata
no,
acá.
No.
Eso se trata acá.
Pues no porque pues no yo no sé por qué lo la tiraron.
He doesn't understand why a judge Neil Mason dismissed the case. He doesn't understand why he did that. He considered that it was the wrong approach.
But he didn't. Do they understand they didn't make plan payments?
¿Qué pasa con los pagos que se iba a hacer en el plan?
Bueno, no se llevó a cabo el plan porque cambiaron del banco. El banco cambió y le pasó a otro banco, por eso no se hicieron los pagos.
What happened through the confirmation hearing with the Honorable Judge Neil Bason was that there was a transfer from Oakland Servicing to PHH Mortgage. So the plan, it was not feasible. That's what he said.
Okay. All right. You may continue.
Okay, continúa. ¿Qué más quiere decir?
Bueno, es que yo quiero que me digan por qué es que ellos, si ellos han cobrado ya el seguro de
pero
ellos.
Pero eso no viene acá a esta corte.
Entonces,
la pregunta de honorable appellate panel es que ¿qué es que tiraron el caso? Si usted está de acuerdo o no está de acuerdo con eso. ¿Qué es lo que tiene que alegar?
Sir, you need to... I understand you're having to...
You're
trying, but...
Your position as a Bankruptcy Appellate Panel, it is to find out whether the court made a mistake or not. ¿Usted cree que la corte cometió
and
un error?
The only issue... We can only decide the issue properly in front of us. And that issue is, did the judge dismiss the case correctly?
¿Considera que el juez tiró el caso correctamente?
Pues no, porque pienso yo que no era correcto.
He considers that the court dismissed the case incorrectly, that they could go for an extension to continue discerning in respect to the appellees in those cases, and that case will be defendant, if it was a lawsuit, which now is a lawsuit in there now. So.
Okay.
Oh, pues también pues se ha puesto una demanda porque pues queremos seguir el caso porque no que me regresen a mí la propiedad ya con.
¿Esta es su conclusión?
Pues sí.
Okay. He wants to conclude that he opened a lawsuit against the appellees in the bankruptcy court so he can continue the case.
Okay. That's the relief he wants, or that's just a statement of what he's going to do?
There is no relief of a stay, removal, nothing more than the case was dismissed. So he is going to continue with the bankruptcy case, with the bankruptcy court now, with litigating his demand or his lawsuit against appellees. So this is mainly for the honorable appellate panel to know what is going on. So.
Okay. All right. Any questions?
Thank you, no.
No. All right. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. This will be under submission.